Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. And today we're back with some more Minecraft survival guide. And yeah, today what I did was from the last episode I did some work in the off camera. I was searching for a village, but yeah. And one more thing, I tamed this small wolf. Yeah. Tiny one. I found it nearby the forest behind our house, somewhere over there. There was a spruce forest. I saw it. I got a bone, and you need to feed a wolf bone to tame it, and it will show a color. It will show a color on its collar. I'll show you. Yeah, if you carefully see it on its neck, you can see some red color. Like, that's the default color, I think. That's why it was. I will change it. I'll change the color of my bed too. But I did so much work in off camera. I searched every, like, literally this whole place from the beginning. Like, I didn't want to make that a video because it would be boring actually. And yeah, I discovered a lot of stuff, but not a village though. Searched so much. Maybe I have left a little bit. Maybe I didn't see clearly, but I think I found one village, and I wasn't very happy with that because there wasn't a librarian over there, because librarian and cartographers are one of the most required trading villagers, because librarians can trade you enchanted books for your gear, which I have complete iron gear, and it had been damaged because I fought with a few mobs. Doesn't matter now. Maybe I found one village, but it wasn't that good. I think there might be a few farmers in there, that's all. And I did some mining and all the stuff, but right now I feel like we have progressed quite a bit in the game. We have got our own farm, so even our wheat farm is doing nice. We have a carrot farm. Our sheep and cow farm is really doing its job. I can see it. It's kind of filled. I might separate these both because both are for different purposes. I might make a small barn area. This might be a different cow, not from my thing. Alright, I might make a barn area or something. Maybe in the future episodes I'll make that place my house, and this whole entire area I might make it a little bit better, decorating it, something like that. But if in Minecraft survival world, you have some steps to follow. First, you craft a bed to skip the night always. You need some decent continuous amount of food. If you harvest all this and you don't have any food left, that's bad. You need continuous food, either from animals or from wheat, carrots, potatoes, whatever. You need some food. The third thing is you need to make a house or any place for your chests and crafting area so that you can do all the work over there. And fourth, you go caving down. You find all the resources necessary for your tools and stuff. And out of all those resources, I think we found lapis too, but I'll show you. Maybe I didn't show you. Maybe I did. I don't remember. This is called lapis lazuli. You will find it inside deeper caves. Maybe if you dig deep enough. Maybe I think it's Y coordinate 23 or something. Correct me if I'm wrong. But I found some I found a power bow and I found some random stuff. I didn't think. When I went for exploring, I found some snowballs. I took some snowballs from the snow biome and some bones, I should say, and everything. Right now I don't have anything other than my armor equipped. So what today we are going to do is that's my iron sword. Yep. So what we are going to do today is we'll have this bow too, and I think we are going deep enough for finding our first set of diamonds, I think, because diamonds will be necessary a lot. We have enough iron. 35 iron is not like completely big amount. It will be enough. Further on we will be needing a lot, but still now, right now, it's enough. We need to get some. I'll carry these sticks too. This logs, spruce logs, some cobblestone for building up. Definitely carry a bucket of water, because you might step on lava, and when you get out, you will take the burning damage, which might kill you. And what's the next thing I wanted to do? So I'll fill up the hot bar and I'll say what stuff you need to take when you go for like for some time mining, not like very less time though. These are sweet berries. These give you like one or a little bit more food bar, and not so required though, but you will be needing them for in the early game though, not now. So I think I'll take a little bit more, my cobblestone, or maybe we'll find it down. Why do I think I am to get? Okay, we'll get some wood if we have enough. I'll take this dark oak anyways. We have a lot of sugarcane. We can convert into paper. And we can trade them to villagers if we find any cartographers or librarians. I think we are quite fully stacked. Let's make a crafting table, because we are going to be down over there for a while. And okay, what shall we do? Okay, it's getting dark. I'll do it tomorrow then. But first, I'll say what we should do if you are going in a search of diamonds. Have a bucket of water, have some cobblestone, like anything. If you are going for caving, or like going into the caves and you want to find some resources for your tools, houses, like anything, you need to have these stuff. Bow is not necessary. You might take it. You don't want to take it. It's your wish completely. Keep a sword, like, because there will be some hostile mobs. You need some pickaxes, a crafting table if you want some more, if you want to craft some more pickaxes, and yeah, some sticks or just logs. You can convert logs into planks and planks into sticks, right? So that will be necessary. And torches, I forgot. That's what. Yep, I have 26 torches, huh? Nice. So torches will be the next one, because you need to light up the place as you go. And you will need some food, like a little bit of food you will need, and extra just in case you need to bring it. Actually, let's not, because you will be getting a lot of resources and we don't want to waste it just for our food and stuff. We'll take coal though. That's it. We'll sleep. And yeah, you will need some building blocks or dirt or cobblestone, which you will not need right now, just to build up if you want, because caves will be steep and stuff. You might want to dig down, and if you want to get up from a sticky situation, you need that. And bucket of water if you find yourself in a lava cave and you are digging for diamonds, and accidentally if you hit the lava, you get on fire and need to stop it using a water bucket though. So what we'll do today is how to get diamonds. So there are two ways for getting the like getting diamonds the most efficient way. One way is called strip mining. The second way is called, I think it's called branch mining. Yeah, I think it's called branch mining because both the names itself suggest it. Actually, I think I have a better idea, you know. What I will do is, I'll build a cave going downwards into, through my house, because whenever if I want some food or something materials, I can just come back through this cave. And not saying you can make this place a little bit better, like decorating it's, you can go out, you can make a quarry, you can make a nice cave entrance into the cave you want to go for decorating and stuff. I suggest this kind of caves because not to spoil the decorate, if you want to decorate your house, this might not be the right thing to do. But what I think is, what I do generally is, I'll make these kind of steps to go down so that whenever I am full with resources or whenever I need some food or some extra resources, I'll just come back, follow through the stairs, and I'll get back directly into my house. So I think you can follow that in the early game. Later on, you can block this and you can go or do your own thing, like into big caves and make a big quarry for resources and stuff. But right now, I don't think so it will be necessary for us. Yeah, so let's go down. You need to make this staircase and you need to light up the place though. So you need to go like this. You might encounter some caves when you are going inside deep down. But don't worry, bring a sword with you. You can fight off any mobs if you want. Oh, this is gravel. I'll remove it with. Why there's so much gravel over here? Okay. One thing you can do is, if you place a torch under gravel, all the gravel blocks which fall down, they will break apart. So let's get going then. Yeah, it broke. Luckily, I broke another one. If I wanted one, I can go back. If you place that like that, if you break this block, all the gravel blocks, they will just break into blocks. I'll show you. It will go into your inventory. This is that. And like this, you need to build like a staircase formation, and you need to go down. And I'll say you need to go down at least like, you can see this right on top left, it says position. And when you go down, the thing in the middle, it says 61 62, and if you go down it will get into low digits. So that is y coordinate. You need to get into like y 11 to 12, so you can find diamonds. I'll just skip this part. All right, I'll go, just go down and I'll do it. Maybe, oh, that's a, wait, let me go out and let me see. I think it's thunderstorm outside. That's bad. I think we can sleep now. Means Minecraft and you are thinking like it's still day and why are you sleeping and stuff, right? Minecraft designed such way you can sleep at night and during thunderstorms. Anyway, you will wake up at day itself. Alright. Let me go down. Maybe I think I'll make this like a, I'll just make this a staircase down to Y11 and I'll see you down there. So guys, what I did was, I just came from there to here up to 11 why 11 coordinate, because diamonds you can find it below 16 and above 5th coordinate, I think. So why I chose 11, because, and not only me, most of the players agree, they generally choose 11, 12 or 10th. Oh, we came across a lava lake. Actually it's a lava pond, but still. So why many people suggest digging around 11, 12 and stuff, because that's exactly the mediocre, I should say, because 11 isn't too high or isn't too low for finding diamonds. So that's the reason. Okay, let's block this. Actually, let's not waste it though. If you pour water on what you say, not flowing. Oh, it continues into a cave. Yeah, you will run up. Wait. Nice iron. Yeah, you will see many caves. Oh, okay. You'll see many caves if you go for cave mining. At least if you go like this, if you follow this way. Oh, okay. My shield is there to protect me. Uh-oh. I'm doing bad. Uh-oh. Okay, the zombie is attacking the skeleton. Wow. Because the zombie got shot by the skeleton first. Did you see that? Okay, some more lava. We'll find some diamonds over here. I highly believe. And this is a big cave, I should say. It's nearby the other ravine we saw before. We went digging right over there. So let's get a little bit down and see. Diamonds will be inside this stone, gravel, dirt, ores. There occasionally sometimes you will find them. Okay. No, thank you zombie, thank you. I almost went into lava over there. It pushed me back. Okay, let's stop this. Yep. Lava, that's lava. And when water falls on still lava, like the lava isn't moving, right? If water falls over there, then it becomes that black thing, like black substance. It's so hard, it can be only broken by a diamond pickaxe. It's called obsidian. So let's get this iron and let's search if we find. Oh, that was a small glitch. I don't know. Yeah, I think it might be the lag or something. Okay, so yeah, this thing is called obsidian. Like, you can mine stone and this stuff really quickly, but you see, obsidian takes a whole lot of time, and you can't break it with a stone, iron, or any other type of pickaxe other than diamond pickaxe in 1.14 and below it. 1.15, I think. I think there's going to be a new pickaxe. I think it's going to be nether update. So I think it already released for some beta version, but pocket edition it didn't. So we'll wait until it releases. But first we'll go up. Yeah, these staircases which we built artificially. What are you doing in my house, huh? I killed your llamas once, you remember? Okay, let's see what is it. Okay, heat reds, some red sandstone, some blue eyes, and some. Oh, slime balls. I might need it. Slime balls? I don't think so. Now, what do we need? I think we can make leads out of slime balls. And what else? Oh, it will not be in here. Yeah, why did I come here? For getting the iron pickaxe. Did I make one? I don't think so. I made one. Okay, what we'll do is we'll put all the rest in this. How did I get birch? Okay, let's Yeah, crafting table will be with me. Iron pickaxe is what I need right now. I think that's all. I'll go down. Yeah. What was I saying? What? Yeah, you need to stand over here properly. Hey, my pup grew up. Alright. So replace these blocks with stair blocks, because like this, if you fall or jump, you will lose a lot of food bar over there on the top. I think it's called, it's generally called hunger bar. Why do I keep saying food bar? Okay, if you will lose a lot. So yeah, we will eventually convert this into like complete stairs, or maybe even block this. But if we find some diamonds, and I might think of. Okay, let's get this redstone. Yeah, hope so there's no lava close by, because this redstone will, if it falls, not only redstone, any block, if it falls in lava, no? Like it burns. Yep, I'll show you. Let's mine this cobblestone. Let's mine this one too. And if we mine that, yeah, lava will eat that up. Eat, like, you understand, right? What do I mean? Okay, so we will find some diamonds in this level beside lava lakes and stuff, because that might be a good sign. I don't say every time you will find it like that, sometimes, most times I should say, the most cases. Okay, we need to be careful, we shouldn't do such thing. Okay, let's block it. Nice. And let's get search for mining.
Okay, so what we will do is, we'll do branch mining first, because strip mining will take some time. And most people call it strip mining because it's divided into like strips and stuff. I'll show you what's branch mining. You just choose the direction and you go straight ahead. Okay. I have a shovel. Okay, so strip mining is like, you choose a direction, you go like straight ahead, and what you do is, you divide this path into branches by going like left or right, or just moving around but in like horizontal straight paths. So that's called branch mining, but often people call it strip mining though. Let's light this place up, and I'll, okay, my torches are low. I have a shovel. How can I forget that? How many times have I forget that? Okay, let's make some torches and let's begin.
Wait. Oh, so much lava. Wow. This might be useful. And a big cave. I'm actually kind of scared. So, yeah, so lava. We'll search around actually. We might find diamonds though. Because this is a big lava, that the sign can't get any better. This can't get any better. We just need to find some diamonds around this. Come on. Wait. No, 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 it can't happen. Ha! Our first set of diamonds. Wait, I need to be careful though. What if I fall? Okay, let's block it. Let's light this place a little bit up. How? I thought it will take a lot of time. I really expected. But can't get any better though. Nice. How many? Oh, there are a few more. I think it's a 5 vein. I should be careful. Nice. Wait. Don't tell me. Wait. It was right this side. So, okay, I was, yeah, this, I made like, from there I came and I branched out up to there and then I turn a right again, and over here I found this. Huh. Nice, actually. Yeah, first what shall we do is, we'll go directly back to our crafting table. We have 5 diamonds though, which we can make a diamond pick, a diamond sword, diamond helmet and all this stuff. So let's make a diamond pickaxe and let's not use the rest. Let's put these diamonds safely and I'll show you how to mine obsidian. And we need obsidian for getting into nether. I mean, for making a nether portal and even making an enchantment table though. So, while getting obsidian with your diamond pickaxe, place a water source using your bucket right beside the obsidian which you want to mine. And leave it right over there, because you stand in here, you mine it. So even with the diamond pickaxe taking a lot of time. Yeah, see, there was lava underneath, and if we broke it like directly like this, that obsidian piece would fall in that lava and burn. So we wouldn't get that again, or even we might get into that. That's why, look at this, mine stone so fast and obsidian takes so much time. See, obsidian is really hard. I need like 14 obsidian pieces, I think, like 10 for your nether portal and 4 for your enchantment table, I think so. Yeah, it is right. So let's get 14 obsidian pieces. So I'm clearing out this whole place because I will not need this lava anyways right now, but maybe later we will need it. But first, we'll mine it though, anyways. Gari, how many obsidian pieces did I get? 6. So we need more 8. We have 6 over here. And below the lava, oh, that was close. There was a lava source right beside us. And remember, water can placed at one place can only travel up to 9 blocks. So be careful, like you might just go out of the range, like out of 9 blocks, and you might fall in lava. Yeah, let's break this cobblestone. Let's break this one too. And now let's get this obsidian. It's taking some time though. Let's get this as quick as possible. See, the durability of diamond pickaxe is so much more compared with an iron or cobblestone pickaxe, just because it's a rare resource. That shows it's a really rare resource, and you need to use your diamonds carefully and only for some purposes, like getting further into the game. You just don't want to make a diamond shovel right now in the early game when you get diamonds. That was close over there. Yeah, right now in the early game, because diamond shovel might worth something later, but right now will not mine that much of, oh, some iron. Actually, I think I'll get that. Oh, that's lava. Okay, let's close that. Let's place a bucket of water over here and let's get this last few obsidian pieces. We have a lot of obsidian over here, and behind there, back there, we saw like a big lava place. So we will have obsidian for days if we just need one bucket of water and we can convert it into, you know, all this place into just obsidian in the bottom. Let's break. I think we have enough. We have 15. Let's get one more and we'll go. Just like that, only two pieces, doesn't matter right now. And we will need these to make more like obsidian. We need to make many portals. Portals later on in the nether too. Nether portals can be used for traveling far distances. I'll tell you about that later because it's kind of a little bit big topic and might take like the nether episode when we go back into the nether. So we found our first set of diamonds, made ourselves a diamond pickaxe. We have other two, we need to preserve them. Need to get some wood, and actually we have enough wood. I think we can make many chests and which we can just arrange it. And I think I have spent a lot of time under there. I don't even see the moon anywhere. Maybe it's above us. Hello. Okay, so we'll put this back. Okay, we'll put almost everything back right now. And what we'll do tomorrow is we'll just craft whatever we will be needing. So I think making an enchantment table, discussing about the enchantments, and even making a nether portal, though, we'll do that in the next episode, I think. And that's how you find diamonds, though. You go into like Y11, 12, and maybe 10, something like that, and you just need to do the mining. I said it's called branch mining. So we'll put this iron. We got so much iron, we'll have more than a stack right now. Wait, I need a little bit more. Let's get some all the coal. I didn't even get it. Okay, I think this might be the right place to end the video, though. So if you really like this video, please like give some support for this video, because I'm thinking of making this a long-term goal, and maybe just making our house big and making some small goals and making it into each episode. So maybe in the next episode I might do anything, making another portal, maybe making an enchantment table, making a barn for that farm, and even these animals. Anything would happen. I think we'll end this video over here. So hope you guys like this video. Don't forget to subscribe. If you guys have any questions or tips about Minecraft survival, make sure you ask that in the comment box below. And our farm is looking good though. Yeah, make sure you ask that in the comment box below. And I think that's it, guys. Peace out.